Thank you, Monica. I don't know about all of you, but I needed that. Something to just kind of calm me down. How many of you have electricity? Praise God. Praise God. Notice I didn't bring mine here. You and Dad, though. Maybe some others. Last week I was lucky, and this week I'm still blessed. So, life goes on, and we are here in God's house to praise and worship Him together on a day that we call Palm Sunday. Everybody got their palms. So let's have church.
Good morning.
Good morning.
There are a few announcements. Sunday school is at 9:30 on Sunday mornings. Everybody's welcome. Choir practice Thursday at 6:30 p.m. April 6th, there will be Maundy Thursday service here in the sanctuary. It includes a dinner, and that's at 7 p.m. And Pastor Cindy would need to know if you're planning to attend that. Either call the office or let her know. April 7th, Pastor Cindy is holding a Good Friday service here at church at 6:30 p.m., the Way of the Cross. April 9th, Easter Sunday, the community sunrise service at 8 a.m. at Columbia Cemetery. Pastor Cindy will be delivering the message there. All are invited, and if you're interested in breakfast, they will be having that at 8:30 at the Upper Room Fellowship. And our service will begin at 10:30 a.m. Is there any other announcements?
Thank you everyone for bringing your crayons and let's see, what was this week? Crayons and glue sticks. Okay, so this week's two items are going to be dry erase markers. If you can get it, colors, they come in multiple colors, dry erase markers, and they're asking for Crayola washable markers like a 10 pack. So either or, they're kind of more expensive than the pencils were, so you could get one or the other if you could help out. And I appreciate everything you're doing. Back by the box, I got some school supply list printed off. So there's three pages, and there's a pack right by the box on the left. If you want to grab one, it's going to have your K through 8th grade school supply list. Thank you.
Any other announcements?
We did have some food left over from the funeral dinner that was here on Friday. Things like cupcakes and bundt cakes, and I think there's some cheeses. So if anybody is interested in taking some home with them, Donna wanted to keep it here and let us offer it to all of you. And thank you very much for everything that you have done for Donna, because she is very appreciative of it all. And I really do need to know who's coming to Maundy Thursday, because I need to know how much to cook for. So that's the reason for the reservation.
I think there are some croissant sandwiches downstairs too, so please help yourselves, because there is a lot of stuff down there. If you could join me in the opening prayer. Hosanna to the King of Glory.
We sing all of your praises and glorify your name. We gather in your presence and bow before you. We have come to refresh our souls with your presence. You have promised that all who call upon your name will be saved. Your children who call upon you to save us from sin, hardship, and poverty. Guide us to you in each step we take in our lives' journeys.
118, verses 14 to 20. The Lord is my strength and my power. The Lord has become my salvation.
There are joyous songs of victory in the tents of the righteous.
The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted.
The right hand of the Lord does valiantly.
I shall not die, but I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord.
The Lord has chastened me sorely, and has not given me over to death.
Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord.
This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it.
So this morning we're going to take prayer requests just a little different. We hired Victoria to pass around the microphone. So Victoria, if you get the microphone, please. And if there is anybody that has a praise or concern, just raise your hand. Got one in the back, Victoria.
Thanks through the night that they people were out working, doing the electricity, and it came on before April 4th.
Anybody else?
She's a veterinarian in town, and she spent this past week at Cleveland Clinic treating for cancer. So for prayers for healing and peace of mind to get us through all of this.
Anybody else? Good. You want to shut that off, Victoria? Thank you. Please join with me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come into your house this morning to worship and adore you. You are an amazing God. You help us to feel love when we feel unworthy of love. You give to us strength when we are weak. You give to us wisdom when we haven't a clue. You extend to us your mercy and grace when we are not worthy. You sent your Son to save us. He came with the only expectation to do your will. And it was your will to sacrifice him so that we may live. This week, help us to walk with you through his passion, so that we may know just how deep your love is for us, so that we may know better what was done for us, and help us to not take your love for granted, but instead be grateful for it and the one that extends it to us. This week we have seen your love in many places, through the outpouring of love that we have seen at the celebration of life for Ronnie Rouse, through the peace that you had placed in our hearts of those that needed it most, through a phone call from a friend, through a smile or a hug from a child. How do we know it was you? Because it came when we needed it, and it turned our bad day into a good day. Summon our church family and families continue to need your healing. We lift up to you Betty Rubenthal, Lisa Kurtz, and all those, dear Lord, that need your healing hand. So we ask that you extend your healing hand upon each of them, allowing them to be healed, and through it glorify your name. There is a man that I heard of this week. I met a lady named Artie, and her brother-in-law had a heart attack, and on top of that, his car was running, causing him to have carbon monoxide poisoning. The doctors say we will have to wait and see, not giving much hope. But you, the great physician, with you we always have hope. So we ask that you come alongside him and remove the poison from his body, allowing him to have a fighting chance, allowing him to beat the odds. For it is in moments like these that you are seen through your great works. Be with his family and friends. Bring to them a feeling of peace, allowing them to know that you are in control. I'd like to raise Marge up, and I praise God that she's here with us today. But I know, dear Lord, that she has been suffering with sinus issues and congestion for weeks. So we ask you to extend your healing hand upon her. More so, dear Lord, so that she could be healed enough to make her travels to Florida as planned. I ask that you also give her traveling mercies, dear Lord, when she's on her way. There are many without electricity. We ask that you keep each one safe, especially those that depend on electricity for health reasons. And we do join Anne in praising the Lord for the workers that are working to restore the power. We thank you, dear Lord, for them, and we ask you to keep them safe. We ask that you be with our children, especially when they are not in our sight. In schools, in churches, during sporting events and practices. So many things going on where our children are being targeted. We know with you, no one can be against them. So walk with them and protect them, especially when we cannot. For it is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. If you would join with me in praying a modern affirmation of our faith, number 885 in our hymnals. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is the one true church, apostolic and universal, whose holy faith let us now declare. We believe in God the Father, infinite in wisdom, power, and love, whose mercy is over all his works, and whose will is ever directed to his children's good. We believe in Jesus Christ, Son of God and Son of Man, the gift of the Father's unfailing grace, the ground of our hope, and the promise of our deliverance from sin and death. We believe in the Holy Spirit as the divine presence in our lives, whereby we are kept in perpetual remembrance of the truth of Christ.
Remember me.
Can I have ushers come forward, please?
Join me in a prayer of dedication. Holy God, sovereign over power and pain, glorious triumph and deep disappointment, we enter this holy week bringing our tithes and offerings to your altar and leaving them here in the hope we can use them to make the world a more loving and compassionate place. We pray in the name
Jesus.
Today we celebrate communion together, and what a great week to start communion with. Amen. So please turn to page 13 in your hymnals and join with me in the celebration. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night that Jesus gave himself up for us, he took bread, he gave thanks to his Father, he broke that bread and he said to his disciples, "This is my body that will be given for you. Take and eat it, and remember me." When the supper was over, Jesus took a cup and gave thanks to his Father. He showed that cup to his disciples and said, "This is the blood of a new covenant, a covenant for the forgiveness of your sins and of many. So take and drink, and whenever you do, remember." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. May them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. The table has been prepared for all of you, so come and join in communion.
Thank you.
was in the Holy Land, I was actually able to visit the place where they say the upper room was. And the upper room was a huge space. It was more like a fellowship hall. I could imagine a feast, not just the symbolisms, but a feast and a celebration. Because even though the people were there to celebrate the Passover and remember all of the slavery and the bitterness and the tears that they went through, they were more so there to celebrate the freedom. Amen? But Jesus was there to tell them about a new freedom. They didn't understand it then, but as the days went on that week, they came to understand it just as we did. Amen? And Jesus told his disciples then to remember this every time you eat that bread. So today we remember by eating this bread. Remember him. And the whole purpose was to save us from ourselves, amen? The forgiveness of sins. And the cup we hold continues to remind us that our sins have been forgiven by the blood on the cross. So take and drink this and remember me. If you would join with me now in praying the prayer that Jesus himself gave to us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen and amen.
The Old Testament reading today is from Psalm 31, verses 9 to 16. These verses speak of complaints which require deliverance. Be gracious to me, O Lord, for I am in distress. My eye is wasted from grief, my soul and my body also. For my life is spent with sorrow, and my years with sighing. My strength fails because of my misery, and my bones waste away. I am the scorn of all my adversaries, a horror to my neighbors, an object of dread to my acquaintances. Those who see me in the street flee from me. I have passed out of mind like one who is dead. I have become like a broken vessel. Yea, I hear the whispering of many, terror on every side, as they scheme together against me, as they plot to take my life. But I trust in thee, O Lord. I say, thou art my God. My times are in thy hand. Deliver me from the hand of my enemies and persecutors. Let thy face shine on thy servant. Save me in thy steadfast love. May God add his blessing to the reading of his holy word.
And the gospel reading today comes from Matthew chapter 21, verses 1 through 11. Now when they drew near Jerusalem and came to Bethphage, at the Mount of Olives, then Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, go into the village opposite you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Loose them and bring them to me. And if anyone says anything to you, you shall say, the Lord has need of them, and immediately he will send them. All this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, tell the daughter of Zion, behold, your king is coming to you, lowly and sitting on a donkey, a colt, the foal of a donkey. So the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them. They brought the donkey and the colt, laid their clothes on them, and set him on them. And a very great multitude spread their clothes on the road. Others cut down branches from the trees and spread them on the road. Then the multitudes who went before and those who followed cried out, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And when he had come into Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, who is this? So the multitude said, this is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth of Galilee. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
I ask you, dear Lord, to continue to fill all of us with your Spirit, allowing us to feel your presence, hear your voice, understand your words, and leave this place with the desire in our hearts to let the world know of the God that we know. And this I pray, dear Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. So Palm Sunday wasn't mistake. It wasn't just a spur-of-the-moment kind of thing. It was actually prophesied 500 years before it even happened. Weeks before Jesus was preparing to enter into Jerusalem, he was making his way there. I know we've read some scripture that told us just that. But as he was going closer and closer to Jerusalem, his disciples were saying, Jesus, do you really want to go there? Like, don't you remember they tried to stone you? Or don't you remember they almost pushed you off a cliff? Why would you want to go there? They want to kill you. But it seems to me that Jesus kind of ignored their fear. He just kept making his way. Because he knew that his time had come. And it was time for him to do what he came for. I know I shared this probably last Palm Sunday, but I have the vision. You just have the vision of Jesus getting the donkey and sitting at the top of Mount Olives. And once again, that takes me back to the Holy Land, because in the Holy Land, we were on Mount Olive, which is actually where the Garden of Gethsemane is. And when you're in the Garden of Gethsemane and you just look across, you can see Jerusalem and you can see the wall that goes around Jerusalem. And right at that spot is what they call the Golden Gate. Now, when we were there, I remember our guide telling us about why that gate is sealed. It's like blocked off. It's like filled in, just like the wall. I couldn't remember exactly what he said. I don't think I actually heard what he said, why it was sealed. So just recently, I did a look to see, because I was showing pictures to kids above and I wanted to be able to tell them why that was sealed. So the Golden Gate was a very special gate. It was actually the gate that Mary and Joseph had taken Jesus through when they took him to the synagogue to meet with Simeon. They say it's also the gate that Jesus actually rode the donkey into Jerusalem. The reason why I read that gate is sealed is because somebody came up with the idea that we're going to block off that gate so when Jesus returns, he can't get in. I laughed because isn't that funny? Like, why do you think that if you block off this gate that Jesus won't come? They need to read the book and remember that when Jesus was resurrected from the dead, the doors were locked, the windows were locked, and Jesus showed up and said, "Peace be with you." You can't keep them away. I just thought I'd share that with you because I think it's funny that somebody thinks that they can block Jesus out. Anyways, when Jesus was sitting at the top of this Mount Olive on a donkey, and I know I shared this part with you before, on the top of that Mount Olive, Jesus had a choice. Remember? He had a choice. See, it wasn't a one-way street. I know, I was there. We came from the back. We didn't come up the hill. We came from the back. He could have turned around and went another way. But he chose us. He chose us. He rode that donkey down the hill and through the Golden Gate, where he knew once he got through that Golden Gate, there was no turning back. Amen? Yeah. It was the beginning of the end to the beginning. Right?
Yeah.
He chose us. That should make us feel wonderful. And that's the reason for celebration at Easter. Amen? Because he chose us. Not just because he had victory over death, but because he chose us. He chose to save us from our sins. And this week, that's what we think about. Remember about. We walk through it. That's what the Holy Week is all about. So I challenge you, all this week, every single day, take a moment to think about what happened on this day. And remember that Jesus was making his way to the cross for us. Amen? I have to tell you, and I know I mentioned when after Janet Metzger's celebration of life, how there was a joyous feeling within me. And I have to tell you that there was another joyous feeling this week after Ronnie Rouse's celebration of life. I mean, that kind of, to me, like coming out of my mouth and hearing what I just said, it sounds kind of weird, but I'm telling you, there's something something about being around godly people and celebrating in a godly way. I have to tell you that Donna kept coming up to me during the dinner, and she keeps saying, there has been the most outpouring of love that I have ever felt in my life. She said, I've never felt so much love in my life. Like all week long. And she couldn't get over the spread of food. And they kept on thanking the church, and we kept saying, we didn't make the food. We opened the doors and said, come in. They brought the food, we put it out. It's like all of their friends and family just was coming in and just dropping off food. That's why we have some left over. Because Donna said, I have just as much food as here at my house. She didn't need any more. And I looked at her after about the fourth time she told me that, and I said, you know what? That's what heaven's going to be like. Amen?
Yes. Amen.
Every once in a while, Jesus gives us a slice of heaven to experience. So that we can tell others what it really is going to be like. But it's going to be even better than that. God is so good that he even takes the worst of days and turns them into a good day. Amen? Jesus rode that donkey down, and the people celebrated. They celebrated because they knew that he was the one. They knew that he was different. They seen him do so many things that he had to have been sent by God. But you see what the scripture says when they asked, who is this? They said, this is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth of Galilee. So they knew that he was sent by God, but at that moment, they really seriously didn't know that he was the Son of God, the one that was going to save them. They knew that he was going to do something for them, but they didn't know what and how. But we do. Amen?
Amen.
And praise God for his word that tells us that, and praise God for his Holy Spirit that confirms that within us. Amen? I ask you to go through this week and come to the end, to Easter, wherever you are, and celebrate it in a way that represents God's love. Amen? Show the world God's love through your celebration of Easter. Please join with me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we have come here this morning to hear your voice, feel your presence, and I believe you have allowed that. We came here this morning knowing that we were going to hear the story of your entering into Jerusalem. And because of your word, we know the end of the story. And we praise your name for it. I praise your name, dear Lord, for giving us that freedom that only you can give. Help us, dear Lord, to be your church and allow others to know that that freedom could be theirs. And this I pray, dear Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. you would join with me now in singing All Glory, Laud, and Honor, verses 1, 2, 3, and 4, number 280. All of you and all his people said,
Amen.
Amen.